Shit, it's so bad lighting in here. Oh, bad lighting. It's 8:53 a.m. I am getting ready to go to the job interview. Yeah, I ate my breakfast. So, yeah, just... I'm gonna trust that camera. This camera's like a desert. Cameras. Well, my skin is still kind of like, you know, like it's still like from the electrolysis. Like, yeah, a couple of weeks or something. To clear up. Clear up. Sure. Oh, it's 8:54. I have to finish this at. I have to finish this by 9:05 because my train is at train is at 9:19, so I gotta finish this. Why did I become quiet? I'm being quiet all of a sudden. It must be so tiring. I do the same thing. It's like I've noticed that my recent videos have always all been about either going to the job agency or something related to work related matters. Or going to the electrolysis. That happened recently. I only make videos when I go out. I don't feel like making a video. No, I just don't feel like I have much to say at the moment. Oh, I cut my skin here. Oh, the lighting is horrible. I need to get the stupid. I need to get lots of things. Like, oh God, so many things to do. So many things. So the lady I spoke to on the phone, she was kind of positive about my application. So what this place does, I think she's a recruitment consultant, so she's not really the employer. The job is actually somewhere in the city, but she's a recruitment consultant, and so it's, yeah, so I'll be interviewing with her, and I think if she thinks I'm suitable, then she will send me to the actual employer for an interview. Probably. So it's like providing customer service support to people who use software. You know, like legal software. Like I remember using one of those when I was at the at that other place. So I was like, given I have some kind of a background, even if it's very minimal, it's like, oh, so then, yeah. Just see how it goes and. See how that goes. Yes. Yes. Oh, 57. Should call this spot up. This is the most problematic spot, is around here. The lighting is shit. I can't think about that. It's just. The lighting is not good. It's cold. It's cold. Oh, it's winter here. It's winter. Why does my face look really weird? Looks wonky. Oh no, it's 8:59. Oh no. I don't bother to wear anything else. Foundation, that's it. And maybe I'll put a bit of lipstick. I don't wear mascara and modeling. I used to wear all of those things. It's like, I was like, oh, I'll just put this on. Okay, that every second. Check if I'm applying this properly. I'll just say it's hyperpigmentation. It's hyperpigmentation. That's hyperpigmentation. I can't do anything about that. What do you want me to do? Oh no, it's 9 o'clock. I gotta get going. I gotta get going. Basic things. Basic. There are all these sophisticated ways to apply makeup. Should do it. That'll do. As you can tell, I use a lot of tissue paper. It's like, horrible. Oh, my hair is shit. I forgot about that. Remember yesterday? What happened? At least today I brushed it or. Shit. From Target, and I'm wearing a bra today. I don't like wearing those. I'm gonna wear one today. Okay, so I'll take this thing, and I'll take this thing. I should do it. My transport thing. Oh shit, I gotta wait 2 minutes. 2 minutes. 2 minutes. So this is what you look. This is what you look. good. Yeah, 2 minutes. Oh. So I'm always rushing. I'm always rushing. Let's see. Here's my username. The transport thing they have here, it's called Opal. Opal. O-P-A-L. Opal. So it's like a... They moved from a paper system. Oh my god, I only got 552 in it. I gotta top that up now. Thank goodness I checked this. Yes, let's top it up. I put 40 bucks in it. Yes. That should do it. Holy shit. Oh, I gotta get... The thing is, fuck. My name. Why don't I do this earlier? I'm always rushing. Rushing. Okay, let's do this. Oh shit, it's 9:05. I have to go now. Oh shit, I gotta go. Alright, it says it's done. Let me just save that receipt. I save all these receipts in electronic form. I say all these receipts. Oh shit, that's all. I have to clean up my desktop. This is such a complete mess. I mean, on my real desktop and my computer desktop. It's like, what the hell are you talking about? It's a different name. Shit, I'm in the wrong place. Anyway. Okay. Is that me? 9:06. 9:06. Let's log out. Okay, so I gotta go and yes, I gotta go to the interview. Well, at least I don't have to go to that job agency. Oh, thank goodness. I was like, yesterday when she was calling, I was like, I hope it's tomorrow. I hope the interview is tomorrow because I don't want to go to the job agency. It's like, oh, this is so depressing. I'd rather go to the interview than go to the job agency. Obviously. Okay, so, where the hell is my recording monitor? Okay, so I'm going to go now, and yeah.
This is how I look.
Oh my god, I gotta get this. Get the hell out of here! Oh my god, it's so late!
Yeah, so, not too bad. Alright. Yeah, here we
go. I'm walking! I have to feel this. If I don't feel this, it doesn't exist. Oh my dog. Yes, go back now. Huh? Yes. Wait 1 minute, let me check. Yeah, okay, let's go. Check for umbrella. It's raining, god damn it. Anyway, so I'll be going. I mean, just along with a lot of electrolysis, and I think the electrolysis so far has been the most expensive part of my transition. I was seeing this video where this trans woman, she got an orchiectomy surgery in the States, and the total cost for her surgery was like $16,000. But insurance paid most, and she got like some kind of a financial assistance from the hospital, so she ended up paying something like $900. But you know, when I got my surgery, I got it, you know, at the public hospital. So it was yeah. So that's something, you know, like, oh my God, like, I didn't have to pay. So it was like, you know, some people, even I was also concerned, because when the first surgeon I saw, he was like, he was not very trans aware or whatever, so he put me on the private thing, and that would have cost me like $6,000. So to then I saw this other surgeon, and he had a lot of experience dealing with trans women, so doing this surgery, so he put me on the public. And so I was just thinking, like, how I'm gonna, you know, I didn't have to pay that much for my surgery, whereas, you know, I was like, you know, and I was just thinking about that, how like this other trans woman, she had to pay, you know, she had to pay, like, her surgery was $16,000 in the States because of some complications or something. But so far for me, the most expensive thing has been my electrolysis. I think it's cost me thousands of dollars so far. And yeah, it's like $130 for 1 hour. So you can imagine that's gonna cost a lot. Like, for my next appointment, it's like, for my 3 hour appointment, $390. That's what I paid last time, and I missed like, what, 40 minutes. I still ended up paying it. So it's a lot of money, the electrolysis, and then, you know, for 4 hours, like, what, $520? It's like, yeah. So far the electrolysis has been the most expensive, but I gotta go. Bye.
The train.
So I have this seat all to myself. It's like, it's one of those single seats.
It's raining.
So I'm at the place. It's raining. And half an hour early, I'm in some kind of a mall. Some coffee shops and things. Yeah, so try and find this place. It should be like 5 minutes away, so cool. Side. I don't like filming people. Nice little buildings that I've got to get to. Shit. It's a rain. I should be using my umbrella. I think I found the place. Found the place. Freezing.
According to my phone map program, I should be going in somewhere. It might be this building.
Hmm.
missing somewhere there, not here. It should be there. Well, according to... it's so weird. It's this way because I can't see umbrella. So I was waiting there, it's actually here.
Toilet's good. Anyway, so I'm here, so... found the place! Oh, yes, I found the place. I'm a bit early, so, yeah. So I finished the job interview. She was a very nice lady. She was very nice. She was, you know, older, and she was very, very nice to talk to. Nice person. So she said that, you know, she was asking me questions, why didn't you, you know, get a job? And I said, you know, it's hard, it's competitive. And so she's saying she'll try to get this job for me, but if she can't, she'll try and talk to someone she knows in the CBD to get a volunteer kind of work at a law firm. And I said, yes, that'll be great. So I don't know if I'll get this job, but no, it was a good positive experience. See, some people are nice, some people are really nice, and they are looking out for you. I felt like she was trying to help me, which was nice. It was I didn't have any problem with my voice at all. I was like quite confident. This is very different from the interview I had last time, where I felt so intimidated. And I felt like, because there were these two people, I just felt so intimidated there. But here I just felt so confident. Or not, you know, I didn't feel intimidated. I felt very relaxed. So anyway, so I'm gonna go home now. Cold.
Please stay. It's train station. Interesting. Oh, interesting. Oh, shit. What's the rest of the shopping center type thing? I'm gonna sit down here.
Goes to Richmond via Central. First stop, Atama, then all stations to North Sydney, then Nelson's Point, Wynyard, Town Hall, Central, Redfern, Strathfield, Lidcombe, Parramatta, Westmead, Seven Hills, Blacktown, and then all stations to Richmond.
3 minutes. So cold. I'm happy going for this interview.
The next train to arrive on platform 1 goes to...